हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग इमेजिनरी होमलैंड्स बाय सलमान रश्दी। नाउ इमेजिनरी होमलैंड्स इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ एसेज रिटन बाय सलमान रश्दी। इट इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रिकॉर्ड ऑफ वंस राइटर्स इंटेलेक्चुअल पर्सनल ओडिसी। द 70 एसे कलेक्टेड हियर रिटन आर द ओवर द लास्ट 10 ईयर्स कवर एन एस्टॉनिशिंग रेंज ऑफ सब्जेक्ट्स, द लिटरेचर ऑफ द रिसीव्ड मास्टर्स एंड ऑफ रश्दीज कंटेम्प्रेरीज, the politics of colonialism and the ironies of culture, film, politicians and the labor party, religious fundamentalism in America, racial prejudice and the preciousness of the imagination and of free expression. Now Salman Rushdie, as you have already heard his name, is the most controversial writer among Indian writing in English. His first glorious work was Midnight's Children. He is a British Indian novelist and essayist with a focus on the connection and disruptions between the Eastern and Western worlds. He has written a number of novels, story collection, works of non-fiction and 2 books for children. In the year 2007, he was knighted by the Queen of England for his contribution to literature. Now, Imaginary Homelands begins with an image of a photograph in the room where he writes. It is a picture of the house in which he lived as a child, taken before he was born, and he keeps it there to remind him that the past is home, albeit a lost home in a lost city in the midst of lost times. Now, on a trip to Bombay a few years before he wrote the essay, Rushdie saw his father's house again after a long time. Not in black and white, but in glorious technicolor. Rushdie realizes that because emigrant writers lose touch with the physical reality of the places in which they grew up, they necessarily create fictionalized versions of them. That is, imaginary homelands, because he wanted to make it clear that he was wrong about his India, a version of the country he would never claim to be definitive. So the title of the novel, or in fact, sorry, the essay, collection of essay, easily states that imaginary homelands is a kind of a fictionalized creation, imagined homelands is, of course, a native place where the person lived. Rushdie then discusses the fallibility and fragmentation of memory in more general terms. Here, he argues that fragmentary memories are not only inevitable, in fact, they may actually be a virtue in a written as virtue in a writer, as fragmentation made trivial things seem like symbols and the mundane acquired numinous qualities. Fragmentation, you already know, is something is divided into parts and pieces. So what here Rushdie wants to say, that the memories which are in parts, which is in fragments, they appear to be more beautiful, more memorable than the one that which are longer ones or which they are undivided. Now, this fragmentary perception is also a reflection of a human condition. So he is connecting this perception of fragments to the condition of a human being. And here I think I would like to quote the lines from the text when he says, human beings do not perceive things whole. We are not gods, but wounded creatures, cracked lenses, capable only of fractured perceptions. So this is, I think, a very important quote from the text, where Rushdie analyzes the human mind and tries to state the fact that we human beings, we are wounded creatures, creatures who have been wounded emotionally, and we are carrying these wounds since births and generations. And the lenses, the way we look at other people, the lenses in the eyes are cracked, and we are capable only of fractured perception. So we humans we have a personality in such a way that this personality could only be understood in fragments, not as a complete whole. Thank you so much.